Hello, Bayview community, and welcome to this Vespers service. Today marks the sixth Sunday after Pentecost, and we'll continue this week with our sermon series on the fruits of the Spirit. And I thought I would read the verse that our series is based on. It's Galatians 5, verse 22 and 23. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. There is no law against such things. So each week, we will focus on one of these fruits of the Spirit. Last week we did love, and this week we will be focusing on joy. So please feel welcome. Know that however you're feeling, whatever you're bringing today, you are welcome. All of you is welcome here. Our first scripture reading today comes from the book of Psalms, Psalm 16, verses 7 through 11. I bless the Lord who gives me counsel. In the night also my heart instructs me. I keep the Lord always before me. Because God is at my right hand, I shall not be moved. Therefore, my heart is glad, and my soul rejoices. My body also rests secure. For you do not give me up to Sheol, or let your faithful one see the pit. You show me the path of life, and in your presence there is fullness of joy. In your right hand are pleasures forevermore. As is our custom, I would like to welcome you to a time of centering, to allow yourself to arrive. And today I'll be inviting us to meditate on a short verse from Exodus, Exodus 3, verse 14. It's when Moses asks God, who should I say is telling me this message? Who should I tell the people of Israel that that you are, God? And God says to Moses, I am who I am. In the last year or two, that verse has really spoken to me. And this image of God being existence or life itself, being itself, is really powerful to me. And this idea that our own existence is grounded in God brings me joy. So I invite you to first just feel your feet on the ground and feel your body in your chair. Become conscious of your breath, and I invite you to take a few deep, slow breaths. I invite you to allow your attention, your presence, your being to be here and to be now for the next 20 minutes or so. And as we sit here breathing and being, I invite you to think about how our existence is miraculous and awe-inspiring. And that for some of us, we believe our existence is because of God, that we are here because God willed us to be here. So I just invite you to luxuriate in that knowledge, that mystery, that we are connected to God simply by being breathing human beings. And I invite you to bring your attention back to the service.
Listen to the music. this special gift of love, more precious than silver or gold. He was sent this holiday to take all our pain away.
Oh, joy,
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 joy in my soul.
Joy in my soul.
Oh, joy,
ooh,
joy,
joy
in my soul.
Our gospel reading today comes from the Gospel according to John, chapter 15, verses 4 through 5 and 9 through 11. Jesus said, "Abide in me as I abide in you. Just as the branch cannot bear fruit itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, and you are the branches. Those who abide in me and I in them bear much fruit, because apart from me, you can do nothing. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and your joy may be complete." In thinking about joy this week, I did some, reading and research on this passage we just read from the Gospel of John. And one of the pastors that I read commented that this section is from what people call the farewell discourse, that Jesus is, saying goodbye to his beloved friends, his followers, telling them, that I'm going to die a violent death and I'm not going to be here with you in the same way. So I'm sure in some ways the disciples thought it was strange that Jesus is talking about joy. So even though the service is focused on joy, and joy is, I believe, a gift from God and a fruit of God's Spirit living in us, it doesn't mean that we always have to be happy. There's a lot in the world that's very sad and hard now and always. And Jesus was far from ignoring that fact or not thinking about it. But how is it possible to also have joy? I think joy is something deeper than happiness or enjoyment, even. I guess when I think about joy, I think about a very deep inner sense of security. And that reminds me of what Jesus was talking about in the passage, abiding in God, that apart from God, we can do nothing. And so it's this security that just to know or to have this faith or to remember that our source is God, and that's a mystery. And it's a mystery and an amazing wonder that we are here and drawing life from God. And there's something about remembering that in the midst of everything that brings me a sense of peace, even when things are really hard. And I guess I think of that as being joy, kind of a quiet, still, sure sense of being okay. But there is also, I think, a place for exuberant joy. And there are things that, it's been a hard time for a lot of us these last couple months with the pandemic and lots of other things going on too. But I know that there are things just in everyday life that bring me joy. So if I get to see a bird or an animal out in nature, I feel joy. It seems to be almost something it's always a gift. I'm always really excited. Over the weekend, I saw a squirrel gathering up grass clippings to make a nest, and it was just adorable and sweet. And something about seeing creatures out in their natural habitat, living their life in the midst of everything, is hopeful and joyful for me. and seeing the beautiful sights. Whenever Seattle has a clear day and we can see the mountains, I just feel a sense of awe and a sense of joy at just the enormous beauty all around us. I think I always feel joy when I get to share a sense of connection. But lately, in the absence of being able to hug people, in the absence of being able to gather in groups, I think I really notice the joy I feel when I get to connect with someone, even if it's a stranger from 6 feet away wearing masks, to share a joke, to laugh together. There's something about being able to be understood or connecting with another human being that I think provides deep joy for us. Knowing that we're cared about and known, I think that's so joyful. And getting the opportunity and the privilege of allowing someone else feels comfortable enough to open themselves up to us so that we get to know someone else. I think that is joyful. So even in hard times, there is joy. And I'm grateful to get this time to remember with all of you that it is a miracle that we are here and that it comes with lots of challenges and hardships. And sometimes maybe we don't want to have to deal with everything that being here entails. As you've probably heard, psychologists say that it's not possible to block out one emotion without that affecting all your other emotions. So if we refuse or feel like we can't handle great sadness or grief, it's going to affect our ability to also feel joy. So our emotions and our ability to feel is a great gift, even when it's hard, because it reminds us that we are deeply and fully alive and connected to our God and to each other. I'd like to invite us into a time of prayer. And I'll just invite some little bit of silence and stillness to tell God whatever it is that's on your heart. And then I will offer a prayer that was written by St. Ignatius of Loyola, and you may be familiar with it. It's probably one of the most well-known prayers of his. Take, Lord, and receive all my liberty, my memory, my understanding, and my entire will. All I have and call my own. You have given all to me. To you, Lord, I return it. Everything is yours. Do with it what you will. Give me only your love and your grace. That is enough for me. Amen. For our final blessing today, as I send us out into our week, I thought I would use a verse from Paul's letter to the Romans. Paul writes a lot of beautiful blessings on his community, and a lot of church traditions use them in liturgies, and so I will do that today. So, beloved, may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and each other. Amen.
Joyful, joyful Lord, we adore thee. God of glory, Lord of love, hearts unfold.